Hi, my name is Vincent, and today I want to take a look at a volume of solids word problem. So we have Farmer Babel's favorite pig is Hadley, but she has been constipated for 2 days. To help Hadley, Babel pours prune juice into a 5x3x2 foot rectangular feeding tub. If the prune juice comes in cylindrical bottles with a radius of 0.5 feet and a height of 1.8 feet, how many bottles will Babel need to fill the tub completely? So the first thing we want to do is label everything we can with the information that was given to us. So we know that this is Hadley, the pig. And we have this rectangular feeding tub has dimensions of 5x3x2 feet. So we could label the length of this tub to be 5 feet. We could label the width to be 3 feet. And finally, we could label the height to be 2 feet. Next, we were given that the radius of the cylindrical bottles, they all have a radius of 0.5 feet, and each of these bottles have a height of 1.8 feet. So now that everything is labeled, what should we do next? We should find the volume of both of these solids. And in general, when we have a rectangular prism, the volume of a rectangular prism, which we'll denote with VR, is equal to the length times the width times the height of that rectangular prism. So now we know that the length of this rectangular feeding tub is 5 feet. So now we can start substituting. We have a length of 5 feet, and we're going to multiply that by the width, which is 3 feet. And finally, we can multiply that by the height, which is 2 feet. So now once we multiply all this together, we have that the volume of the rectangular feeding tub, we have 5 times 3 is 15. 15 times 2 is 30. So we have 30, and now feet times feet times feet is feet to the third power. So now we would say that the volume of the rectangular feeding tub is 30 cubic feet. So next we want to find the volume of each of these cans of prune juice. So we have the volume of a cylinder. The general equation for the volume of a cylinder is pi r squared times h, which is the height. So now we have the volume of this cylinder is equal to pi times the radius squared, but the radius in this case is 0.5 feet. So we're going to square this quantity and multiply it by the height, which is 1.8 feet. So we have 1.8 feet. So now when we work all of this out, we're going to have pi, and now 0.5 squared is 0.25. So we're going to have 0.25, and now feet times feet is feet to the second power. So we have 0.25 feet squared times 1.8 feet is going to give us 0.45. And remember, this is all cubic feet, because we're going to have feet times feet times feet like this. Your calculator will work all this out for you. So you should get 0.45 pi cubic feet. So now the question, how many bottles will Babel need to fill this tub completely? Well, let's say that Babel is going to need X bottles to fill the tub completely. What is the volume of each of these bottles? We just found the volume of each of these bottles to be 0.45 times pi. I'm going to write it that way instead. The volume of each bottle is 0.45 times pi. And remember, this is all cubic feet. And we'll set this equal to the volume of the tub, because we want to know how many bottles we're going to need to fill the tub. Well, we know the volume of the tub is 30 cubic feet. So now the last step in this problem to find out how many bottles we're going to need, we're solving for x. We're just going to divide both sides by 0.45 pi cubic feet. We're going to do the same thing on the right side, 0.45 pi cubic feet. And now on the left hand side, 0.45 pi cubic feet will cancel. And now on the right hand side, cubic feet will cancel. And now what we need to do is, in our calculators, we need to do 30 divided by, and I would put parentheses, 0.45 pi. And you should get 21.22. So we have x is equal to 21.22. And remember, when you put this in your calculator, I would put parentheses around 0.45 pi, because your calculator will mess it up and give you a different value if you don't put those parentheses. So now how do we interpret this answer? X equals 21.22. How many bottles will Babel need to fill the tub completely? Well, assuming he's going to a cellar to grab these bottles, he's not going to grab 21 bottles and a fraction of a bottle. So the full answer to this is going to be Babel needs 22 bottles, because we can't have a fraction of a bottle. So he's going to go to the cellar and he's going to grab 22 bottles for this poor pig Hadley. And I'm sure these 22 bottles of prune juice will do the trick and restore Hadley back to her happy state. Okay, well, this is going to conclude this volume of solids problem. Thank you all for watching, and I hope this video was helpful.